So if you had told me 2 days ago that Hutch was going to resign from Machinima and move on with his life, I probably would have said, good for him. I mean, you know, it's not going to impact me that much. It doesn't really have anything to do with me, honestly. But when I found out a few hours ago, it really struck me differently. You know, it hit me a lot more personally than I thought it would. And by no means is this me saying that I disagree or feel that his decision is wrong, because that's no place for me to say. But it really did make me reflect a lot on my own place here on YouTube, you know? And by no means am I as popular as Hutch, you know? So it is even more powerful in that regard to know that, you know, my time could be approaching where I'm going to have to, you know, put down the mic and say I'm done with this. Or, you know, it might not even be that formal. It may just come to the time that I can't think of funny stuff to say or entertaining things to say, and I have to make the uploads fewer and far between, and then eventually my audience will just leave, which is fine. You know, people have changing tastes, and maybe someone who finds me entertaining right now in a year will think I'm an annoying douche, and that's totally their right. But it really just made me think about this whole YouTube thing and how it's impacted my life so much, because you can tell in that video that even though Hutch and Sark are, you know, being nice about it and talking and having a good time and reminiscing, you can tell that it's weighing heavily on both of them. You can always tell from the videos they work in together that they really do have chemistry and they're good friends. And so it was weird. But more than anything, I thought about the opportunities that have been given to me on this YouTube thing. And this has nothing to do with monetary opportunities. This is solely just the other stuff that people don't even think about on YouTube. And by that I mean nobody else really in the general population knows what it's like to have a fan. Think about it. Nobody knows what it's like to have a fan. Now, I'm not Lady Gaga or Justin Bieber, and I don't have a bunch of sycophants fawning over me nonstop, but I do know what it's like to have people who think that I am generally cool just because of the videos that I make. And you know what? It may sound lame, but that makes me feel pretty good inside. It makes me happy to think, hey, even though in real life I'm not this awesome, just stellar, hilarious stand-up comic of awesomeness who is just badass, you know, on the internet, some people think I'm like that, and that's cool. And it's cool that you have fans like that, because obviously the same can be said for every celebrity and sports star, since obviously they all look better in their public persona than they do personally. But for me, it really got me thinking, you know? Nobody else that I know in my life, aside from people I've met through YouTube, know what it's like to have someone who just generally enjoys you and thinks that the things you say are intelligent and worthy of listening to. And that feels good, you know? And I don't even get a shit ton of views on my videos. I don't get a lot of views at all, relatively. And it still makes me feel good like that, you know? And it really made me reminisce on that. What's it gonna be like when I finally end this YouTube thing and, you know, I'm not gonna have that ability anymore. I'm not gonna have the ability to upload a video and talk about a relevant political issue and get immediate feedback. I won't have that luxury. I'm gonna have to fade back into the regular populace, not to say that I'm, you know, above everyone now, because that's ridiculous, but I'm not gonna have those opportunities anymore. And what's that gonna be like for me? Is it gonna be easy to just suddenly forget all the people who supported me, or is it gonna be hard? You know, I imagine that it's going to be really hard, because it seems like this YouTube thing is almost like an addiction, you know? Because once you start getting into it, you love the fact that your fans and supporters like you, and when you get positive comments and whatnot, it makes you want to put out more videos to keep everybody happy and have a good time. And so it's just, it's strange. And I apologize if I'm rambling more than I usually do. It's just I'm trying to get this off the cuff and get my honest opinion out there. But really, it's just strange. It's strange to me that this whole YouTube thing is ending, you know? And even when I saw Hutch, I can still remember the day that I saw Hutch's video where he announced that he was getting a job with Respawn, and I felt vicariously excited for him. I was really happy about it. I thought, awesome, this is like the final step in his quest for happiness in life. He's finally found that niche where he can get along with people, where he can pursue a goal that he enjoys and have fun. And for me, albeit myopically focused and short-sighted, I thought that that was kind of the end of Hutch's journey, and that he was going to stay here and fill us with, you know, intimate details of his life from now on, forever and ever, amen, you know, and that's what I thought. Never before did it cross my mind that, hey, maybe this really isn't what Hutch wants. Maybe this is just one of those jobs that he thought would be super awesome, and then, like everything else, it wears and tears on you, you know? And so it made me think like that. It made me think about what am I going to do when I, you know, graduate from school or graduate school or whatever I decide to do, and then move on to a job. Am I going to hate it in 4 years, or am I going to be so tired of it that I won't be able to cope? And it's really, it's just strange for me, you know? Because you have to admit that everyone who saw Hutch's video from a few years ago where he talked about getting on Respawn We all thought that was the end of the story. We thought that he was going to be, you know, the knight in shining armor of Machinima from then on out, and that's just not the case. And this is coming so soon after C-Nanners leaves Machinima, and it's just a really poignant reminder of how finite and how fickle people are on the internet. And that's not a bash on the internet. People, like I said, their tastes are inclined to change, and that's completely within their right. But as far as I can tell, you know, my time is coming as well. You know, who knows? It could be a year from now. It could be 6 months from now. It could be 5 years from now. Who really knows? And that's the point. And so it may seem weird and kind of cliche, but that's what I want to talk about, really, or that's what I hope I expressed cogently enough, is that just seize the day with this whole YouTube thing, you know, because you never know when it's going to end. And even if it seems that the person who's making the content is perfectly content, you really can't tell, you know? So I apologize if this was, you know, just long-winded and terrible, but I hope you guys enjoyed. And Hutch, you will be missed.